I would say there are two critical aspects to film noir. One is the visual language and one is the story language. The visual language, like horror, it comes extremely influenced by German expressionism, a cinema of chiaroscuro, of light and shadow.
I grew up with film noir. You know, they were people's movies. They weren't fancy Hollywood. They were tough, pessimistic, scary fantasies.
It's ultimately a moral decision genre. You have characters that have not and try to get it through violence. They try to break that barrier that society denies them. That makes it a really interesting existential American tragedy.
And of course, I loved that they were vital and they were kind of B-movies.
The commonality between noir and tragedy is the inexorable. You know it's gonna end bad.
That's very attractive to see these desperate stories. You could empathize with these people, but there was always a little bit of it. I understand, but that's not me.
When people talk about noir, people think immediately of a cliche, a perfume ad, you know, Venetian blinds, voiceover, detective in an overcoat in a wet street, slow-moving fan, smoking dame in the half shadow. That's not noir. The figure of the femme fatale, they were women with agency, and they got it any way they could because the game was rigged.
This fate of the world and themselves in the world, that's very attractive when you're a young kid and you're trying to figure out who you are.
I actually like a lot of lesser known noirs, you know, Born to Kill, Too Late for Tears. The brutal, inexorable quality of noir is that the wheels keep grinding these characters. It's a beautifully brutal genre.